We're now ready to discuss clinical trials, a very exciting topic. So we'll learn about what happens at each stage of the different clinical trials and how all the clinical trials collectively help determine the safety and effectiveness of a potential drug. To test a lead in humans, a drug company must submit an investigational new drug application, or IND, with the Food and Drug Administration, the FDA. The IND application details the lead's preclinical data, including evidence of efficacy, completed toxicology tests in animals, and manufacturing information. If the FDA does not raise objections within 30 days, then the company will initiate clinical trials. Clinical trials are safety and efficacy tests performed in humans. The first stage is phase one. Phase one trials involve 25 to 75 healthy volunteers. Phase one test subjects do not have the disease of interest. Phase one trials determine safe dosing levels. Researchers also learn about what type of side effects, more properly called adverse drug reactions, or ADRs, the patients might show during later trials. Phase one trials monitor safety. But signs of efficacy may also be apparent even though the test subjects are healthy volunteers. For example, if a molecule lowers cholesterol, then researchers will monitor cholesterol levels for early signs of efficacy. Phase two trials typically enroll several hundreds of patients. Phase two test subjects do have the condition treated by the lead. Phase two trials begin measuring efficacy. Phase two trials are often subdivided. Phase 2A explore a range of doses. Phase 2B trials focus on a narrow dosing range to balance efficacy and any adverse drug reactions. Phase 2B trials are often called pivotal trials. Phase 3 trials enroll a large pool of patients, maybe 1,000 to 3,000. Again, these are patients, not healthy volunteers. Large numbers allow the measurement of efficacy in a range of patients and test the performance of the drug candidate against known treatments. Known treatments are called the standard of care. As with other phases, safety remains a concern. Once clinical trials have been completed, all the data, preclinical and clinical data, will be collected into one large application, the New Drug Application, or NDA. The FDA reviews the entire dossier. If the data show the candidate molecule to be safe and effective, then the molecule will be approved. The NDA review requires about 12 months. The FDA can only approve a drug for use in the United States. Approval in other countries requires separate filings with other drug regulatory agencies. A new drug, like those found in an oral capsule or tablet, is called a new molecular entity, or NME. Sometimes these are called new chemical entities, or NCEs. We've now seen the drug approval process, starting from clinical trials, and how in clinical trials we gather data for a lead's activity in humans to determine ultimately by the FDA whether the molecule is safe and effective for approval and use in humans.